Hello everyone, Danas here with ActionVFX. In this quick tip tutorial, we are going to learn how to add a fake gun recoil, which in this case, a rifle recoil, into your shot. We have done previous tutorials focusing on other gun effects, such as muzzle flash or bullet shells ejections. So in this one, we will be focusing on how to add that pushback or recoil that you get from firing a rifle. Before we begin, don't forget to click the subscribe button and hit the bell icon so you will be notified for our future tutorials. So, without further ado, let's begin. So, this is going to be a very simple effect. First, we're going to need a plate of just our talent holding the rifle without firing anything. And then we're going to duplicate the plate, mask out the rifle and other body parts that are affected by the recoil, and then nudge their position a bit. And then have them to only appear for just a couple of frames. And that's it. Now, let's start creating this from scratch. Okay, so here we have our original plate. First, let's decide when we want the rifle to discharge. Let's say around frame 9 here. Now let's Ctrl D to duplicate our plate. And then the first thing we're going to do is we are going to select the rifle itself. So let's grab our pen tool here and mask around our rifle. And don't forget some part of the forearm as well, because those forearms are going to get recoiled along with the rifle. And then let's feather our mask here. Okay, so now let's use the arrow keys on our keyboard to offset the rifle a few pixels to the back. And then what we also want to have is the front part of the rifle to rotate upwards a bit as it gets pushed back. So let's select pan behind tool and move our anchor point to the middle of the arm here. That way, the rotation swing of our rifle will pivot on that point. Now let's bring our rotation and set it to -2. And there we go, the rifle is pointing upwards. Alright, so our recoil offset here is revealing the pixels of the bottom plate. So let's fix that by just extending the mask of our rifle here. Now let's add keyframes on both the position and the rotation of this layer. And then let's move forward 2 frames. And then we want to ease this back to its original position. So right click and fit to comp. And there we go. Now let's trim the beginning and the end here to match the keyframe. You can do that by holding Alt and then close and open bracket. And this is what we have so far. Next, to polish this, we are going to add directional blur and rotate the blur direction to the same as the recoil, and then increase the blurriness really high. And then we are going to add a keyframe to the blur amount at the beginning of our recoil here. And then as the recoil eases back, we are going to ease down our blur as well. Now let's rename our layer here. Okay. Next, we are going to do the recoil on the other part that is affected, which is the upper torso. So let's duplicate again, and we want to mask the upper body, including the upper arm. And then once again, we want to offset it to the left here. And then we are going to add keyframes on the position. Move forward 3 frames. And then again, right click and fit to comp. Now, on the last part here, we can see that our mask has veered away from where it's supposed to be. So what we want to do to fix this is go to the mask path settings, turn on the keyframes, and animate auto masks to follow the plate. And then once again, we are going to trim our layer here accordingly. And then we are going to add directional blur again. And also keyframe it. Perfect. And finally, we are going to repeat almost the same process with the head. So let's duplicate our plate again and let's mask our head. And for the head, we actually want it to offset to the right instead of to the left, because the head is compensating for the recoil instead of being carried backwards by it. Now here, let's fix the edge issue again. And then we're gonna add keyframe to the position once more. After that, we're gonna go 2 frames forward and then fit it back to comp. Now we can see the mask is not matching again, so let's fix that. Let's go to the mask path and animate it. And then let's trim this layer. Next, let's add directional blur. And there we go. Lastly, I want my recoil here to be more powerful. So let's go back to my main rifle layer again. And then I'm gonna push the recoil back a bit further. And then also rotate it upwards a bit more and fix the mask. And then let's also push the body recoil to the back a bit more as well. And then I want to turn on the motion blur button on my layers here to make it look like it's moving even faster than it is. And finally, duplicate the plate and redo the recoil process again on other parts of the shot to add more recoils into the sequence. And you also want to add some VFX elements from our ActionVFX stock footage collection, like bullet shells, gun smokes, and muzzle flash. And of course, the tutorials on how to composite these elements are in the description below. And that was how to create fake gun recoil in post-production. If you want to purchase the assets that I used in this tutorial, as well as other high-quality VFX stock footage, you can check out our website at actionvfx.com. At ActionVFX, we provide high-quality VFX assets for your VFX needs. We have fire, explosions, energy, and many, many others. You can also sign up for our ActionVFX subscription starting at the low cost of $14.99 a month. This is the most affordable way to access our library, and you can cancel anytime, no contract. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and let us know in the comment section below what kind of tutorials that you'd like to see next. And see you next time. Bye-bye.